Video 2, Parts 1 and 2. Let's start with Parts 1 and 2 of Form EIA-857. Part 1 is respondent identification data. Part 2 is submission information. Part 1, respondent identification data. If you look at Part 1, you see a space for your EIA ID number. If you don't know your company's ID number, please contact EIA staff and they will give you your ID information. Beneath the ID number, the form asks for your company's contact information. If this is your first time reporting the EIA 857 form, let EIA staff know as soon as possible. Then you can list your contact information in Part 1. This training video is designed to help you understand the form after you've read the instructions. You may want to save the link for this video to share with your company's future points of contact in case your responsibilities change. Part 2, submission information. If you look at Part 2, you'll see several options for submitting your form to EIA once it's complete. EIA accepts the form via mail, email, fax, or secure file transfer. Please note that your EIA 857 form is due 30 days after the end of the reporting period. For example, this means that the report for October is due by November 30th. If you aren't able to submit the form by the monthly deadline, please let EIA staff know as soon as possible. That was easy, right? Let's move on to Parts 3 and 4 of the form.